Our next guest, not Josh, yes, Josh, is back and he's delighting us with his stand-up. Please welcome Josh Thomas.
Maybe it's Josh Thomas.
No, you've lived in LA for a few years. How's it feel to be back?
I'm really happy to be back in Australia. I can't do it with the Americans anymore.
Why?
Well, they always want me to be excited. They're always like, hey, Josh, you're excited about dumb stuff too. Like, you're excited for dinner? No, I'm like, I've been to dinner so many times. Are you excited for a Zoom meeting? No, I'm not excited for a Zoom meeting. That word means something. You know what I mean? No, I'm not excited. And I can tell you why I'm not excited. It's because I'm an adult. I haven't been excited about anything since I was 12. Do you know what I mean? I've been excited for 28 years. And then whenever I say that to them, they seem really let down. But nobody here wants me to be excited. Everyone in Australia just wants like to have a nice time.
And your new show is actually very adult as well. It's about trying to figure out how to do the small things in life. Is that right?
Yeah, it's about, okay, so it's about, it's a bit more long-winded than that. How much time do we have? It's about, okay, so 9 years ago I got diagnosed with ADHD, and I know talking about ADHD is a bit like, because everybody, like 9 years ago it was still on the cusp of being quite interesting, but now everybody has it, right? It's boring. We're in like an ADHD diagnosis bubble, which is like, you can't all have it, actually. Some of you have to not have it. I'm so sorry. And I...
You're special.
I want to be interesting. I want it to be mine. It's mine, it's not yours. I want it to be boring. I'm so sorry. Diagnose that. And I saw this psychiatrist, and I don't think I had a great psychiatrist. When she diagnosed me, she said, you have ADHD, which was a little insulting. And then she followed that up by describing it as being incurable.
Oh.
Which is not the right word to use. You're not meant to use that word to describe my personality, actually. I've never heard that word used to describe anything good, right? I never heard anyone say, wow, this Pavlova is incurable. And so the show is me trying to work out if I am incurable. Because then also I had another diagnosis 2 years later, which was autism, which I was thrilled about because that's actually still interesting. That's got some edge.
Nice.
That's drama. Now you've got yourself a show.
What's the difference? Why does it make it more dramatic?
The difference in autism and ADHD?
Well, for you, why is it more dramatic? Why do you think it's still like...
Well, a lot of people have ADHD, but not that many people have autism.
Right, special.
That's we all know that's more interesting. No?
I agree. I'm with you.
I don't think it's my place to judge which of your ailments or neurodivergent personality traits is more or less interesting, Josh. Yeah. I feel like that's up for you to... But what I can judge is your rockin' bod. I saw this on Twitter.
Wow.
And we have... hopefully we have a video of... No, we don't. Here we go. Yeah. So I didn't realise you're just hiding a massive thirst trap under that shirt.
Yeah.
Look at this. This very real body that you have.
Yeah, that's definitely my actual body. I posted that as a joke, actually, and it's obviously it's not my body. I feel like people in the audience are a bit confused. That is not what I've been up to. I have not been doing that.
Has it? You were trying to promote your show that's coming up. Has it moved in tickets or?
Yeah, actually, that video did well, but I don't know if that's. It's just latex bodysuit, and I was doing it as a joke because you just got to do things on this TikTok to get these people to keep looking at you, you know?
Yeah.
You have to, like, just get their attention for 3 seconds, and that's what I was doing, but then so many people thought that was my real body, and I'm just like, what the... If you see me walking around with that body, that's mental illness.
Are you wearing the suit? You look quite broad right now. Like,
thank you. No, that's just a thick knit.
I love it.
I've heard you're also working on your small talk, Josh. How's that going?
Well, because I've been trying to get cured, I suppose, and I've been because I've been trying to get better at small talk. Whatever I'm talking about, I need to do is I need to ask questions and then listen to the answers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Had you not been doing that before? What were you doing before?
Right. Because I wasn't doing that because I thought when you were a kid, they would tell you have to treat people the way you want to be treated.
Uh-huh. Yes.
But that's not true, actually. That's a lie. It's like Santa Claus and the Brontosaurus and Pluto, right? The only three things I've ever really loved. And because I've always, like, to me, what feels like good manners, because I don't like it when somebody asks me questions that feels sort of like oppressive, like you're forcing me to talk about the thing you want to talk about. But not right now, obviously, because that's the social contract that we're this is the small talk.
Oh my God.
What feels like?
This is big talk.
Yeah, I really demonstrated it. But I. What feels like good manners to me is somebody just like leaving a pause and letting me tell you the anecdote I pre-prepared in the Uber. So I've always just at social events just been looking at people leaving pauses so they can tell me the story, but they didn't pre-prepare an anecdote in the Uber, I guess, because they're lazy. And I found out maybe 5 years ago that that's the wrong thing to do.
Just ask about the weather.
Yeah. How is the weather? I don't care.
You can
could pre-prepare that answer as well. You could just be like,
it doesn't matter. Yeah. Did this go well?
Yes. It did.
Okay.
Yes. Josh is heading around the country with his show, Let's Tidy Up. It's gone so well, you'll want to see it. Ticket details are on our website. Please thank Josh Thomas. Yeah. Love Josh Thomas. Hey,